FSS Cash Tech is predominantly handling cash. When I say cash, cash in and cash out. What I mean by cash in and cash out is, cash in is deposit, cash out is withdrawal. That's why we call it as cash in, cash out network. What we are trying to do is enabling availability of cash across tier 2, tier 3, tier 4 cities and villages in this country, so that they can buy their groceries, they can pay the tuition fees, whatever it is. Availability of cash at nook and corner is what we are trying to do. Why availability of cash? Even latest of the RBI survey a few days back, all low transactions, that means low value transaction means anything less than 100 rupees, people prefer to do through cash transaction even in metros. So you can think of non-metros and tier 2s and tier 3s. So cash is a very important catalyst for digital divide. So we are trying to ensure that cash is available to people across the country. So that's what we do. Currently, we have 40,000 points across the country, and we plan to increase this 40,000 points to about 70, 80,000 points quickly, so that it is available in nook and corner of this country. That is not true. In fact, the April 26th report of RBI still says cash is the king. What they have said is 87% of the people in metros. When I say metros, I'm talking about Bangalore, I'm talking about Chennai, Mumbai, Kolkata, all these metros, 87% of the people would like to pay cash for transaction less than 100. And 57% of the people would like to pay in cash for transaction from 500 to 2000 rupees. So that is the level of people dependence on cash. So one, there is no shifting out of cash. The question is, customer is a king. What is convenient to him, he will use those model to pay. Sometimes it could be debit card, sometimes it could be NEFT, sometimes it could be IMPS, sometimes it could be cash. Whereas metro, urban, rural, convenience of the customer will be the key. And as a cash tech, we are here to provide the convenience across metros and tier 2s and tier 3 in the country. So to answer your question, cash is not declining even in metros. Yeah, there are many challenges which we face now. One, access itself, because many of my ATMs or these devices would be in a containment zone or a red zone or whatever it is. First is, how do I reach that place? That's number one. Number two, with lockdowns, employee itself reaching to a certain place to ensure that we take the van and go and load the cash. So availability of transportation for people to reach the place, that's number two. Third, people itself, with COVID going across nooks and corners of the village, people are afraid. So people coming to work and motivating them to come to work and ensuring that these ATMs are loaded and made available 90% of the time for people to withdraw cash or deposit cash is a big challenge, which is what we are facing today. So access, transport, people, these are all the main challenges which we have today in the market. Yeah, multiple challenges, multiple remedies is what we are focusing on. One is how the access. We have been in touch with the local governments, local corporator, local influencer to enable us to reach out to those access point in containment zone, because this is very, very critical for people to access and withdraw cash. Second, we have mobile ATMs in those places. If I'm not able to access those ATMs, we provide mobile ATM where people will come and withdraw cash through mobile ATM. That's another opportunity we give for people to ensure that they can withdraw the cash. Third, for transportation, we have talked to the local governments to allow us as a essential worker so that they can load into the trains and any of those local buses which are flying across. It's very happy to say that government has recognized our industry as the essential service industry and allowed us to onboard in any of the state vehicles. So that helps us in people getting the transportation. And third, as I said earlier, we have been very, very lucky to have those people who are supporting us as a frontline workers. Many of them have been vaccinated as a part of the essential service. So they are available to us to reach out. So far, we have been able to manage these challenges effectively. Today, our ATMs are available 90% plus for people to withdraw cash. And there has been a word from RBI governor itself saying that ATM industry has really supported them during this pandemic. So I'm really happy to say that we have overcome many of those challenges as an industry. Yeah, as a cash tech, our mission is to empower billion lives. When I say empower billion lives, to bring people into the mainstream by giving them access to financial services. What I call financial inclusion. When I say financial services, I mean access to cash in terms of deposit, withdrawal, remittance, DBT, insurance, mutual funds, anything required for people to come into mainstream. That's what we are trying to do. So we have developed a cash tech platform, which will be launched shortly for people to access so that they can get what they want, the product they want, so that they can come to mainstream. So that is one of the biggest initiatives we are launching this year, reaching out to billion lives through our cash tech platform. And this will be a very, very important initiative and a game changer for the country itself. That's what we hope for. We'll be right back.